Very good morning to all the students. So in the last session we have discussed various cases that are related to delete a node from a red black tree. We have six different cases. What we will do if it is a red node, if you want to delete a red node, what you have to do if you want to delete a black node, and what happens where you have to search for a red node if you have a double black. It is through the sibling or sibling's child, or worst case is parents, right? So all these things we have discussed with six different cases. Now in this session we are going to discuss the same concept but with different examples, right? We'll explore case by case with examples each, right? So while going through this particular concepts, or before going to this examples part, let me quickly recap what we have studied in the previous session, right? Very important points only I am going to discuss. So the first and foremost point which I want to discuss is this one. Deletion in red black tree is similar to the deletion in BST. So whenever you want to delete a node, you have to do it according to the deletion operation in the binary search tree. And the second category of important points that I want to discuss is deletion of a red node from the red black tree does not affect the red black trees, right? But deletion of a black node affects the red black trees. Why? Because there is a change in the black height. When you delete a black node, the black height is changed. So you have to make necessary adjustments again to make that particular node as the red black tree, right? And the third point is, this also we have discussed, if a node is red, assume that it is angry. If the node is black, assume that it is cool. And if the node is double black, we assume that it is a vower cool. So this double black, that means a node with double black or overcool node, is a problem we have here. So we have to search for a red node to share his one part of the black, right? So it cannot, as I told that, the double black node cannot start his search from the entire red black tree. It is having his own restrictions. It can search for a red node either in his sibling or from his sibling's children, where we define it as the far child or the near child. And finally, it can go with the parent also. It can search for a red node in the parent, right? And remember that it cannot share his black in the downward direction, right? He cannot share it with his children. That's it. So he can only share his double black with the sibling or sibling's children or the parent, right? Is it clear? Just a recap of what we have discussed in the earlier session.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now we'll go with the examples. What is case one? We are not bothered about step one. Step one is nothing but BST deletion only. Step two, case one, if the node to be deleted is red, just delete it. That's it. So let us take example this one, example of this one. Can you tell me whether it is red black tree or not? What is the first property you have to check to identify whether it is red black tree or not?
Node should be either red or black.
Super. All the nodes in the red black tree should be either red or black. What is the second property?
Root node should be black.
Root node is black. Okay, satisfied. What is the third property? The null leaves or the nil leaves. We can call it as null or nil. No problem, right? Null leaves or nil leaves are black in nature. And what is the fourth property we have? It is the red constraint. So a red node cannot have the red children. That means no two consecutive reds are accepted in the red black trees. What is the last one?
Black height.
black height, the black height of all the descendant nil leaves or descendant paths, nil descendant paths should be equal. So if you check the last property, that's enough. And the last two properties, that is the red constraint and the black height properties, are checked, that is enough, right? Why? Because we are dealing with the red black trees. Every node is represented either with red or black. Always you keep the root node as black and all the nil leaves are black. All these three cases are somewhat simpler, right? But the red constraint and the fifth constraint, which is the black height constraint, has to be taken care while inserting and deletion. Right. Now, what is the black height of this path?
2, sir.
2, sir.
1 and black nil leaf, which is 2. This one, 2. This one, 2. And here we have 1 and nil leaf, 2. And here we have 2. So, all the paths, nil descendant paths, are having the equal black height, therefore it is a red black tree, right? Now I'm not going to discuss whether it is black tree or red black tree or not, right? This is not our interest. My interest is to check or to implement the deletion operation, right? So let us take the example. So my part here is to delete 30. So what is that you have to do when you want to perform the deletion operation? Which operation it will be augmented? What supplementary operation you have to perform?
Search operation.
Search operation. So you have to search for 30. So 30 compared with 10, since it is greater than, go to its right hand side. 30 compared with 20, since 30 is greater than 20, you go to its right hand side. 30 compared with 30. Here I have identified 30. Right. And what is the color of this 30?
Red, sir.
Red, sir.
Red. And remember that you have to consider the case, whether it is the case 0, case 1 or case 2. Case 1 is nothing but deletion of a node with 0 children. Case 2 is deletion of a node with 1 children. Case 3 is deletion of a node with 2 children. So under which case it will come?
Case 1.
This is case 1, right? So what you have to do is, you can observe here that I have a nil here and I have a nil here. Assume that the nil leaf is represented as a square box, that's it, right? And this is black and this is black. So when you want to remove it, it's a since it is a node with 0 children. 1 minute. So you have to replace it with the child, right? So this becomes black. This becomes black means what is the meaning? So this becomes the leaf node or nil node. Like this. So is there any need to represent the nil node?
No, sir.
No. So you just remove this one. That's it. Now you check whether this particular tree, which is left over after deleting 30, is red black or not. Is it red black tree or not?
Yes, sir.
Right. So after deleting 30, my tree will be like this. Right. So this is the leaf node I have deleted, 30. But what is the case if the red node is the inner node, right? So let us take another example, this example. And this time also I want to delete 30. What is the thing you have to do before deletion? you have to check whether that particular node or the element is present in the red black tree or not. So perform a search operation. 30 compared with 10, since it is greater than, go to its right hand cell. 30 compared with 30, right? So what is the color of this 30?
Red.
This one, this is red in color. And under what case you will come across this deletion part? Is it case 1, case 2, or case 3?
Case 3, sir.
It is case 3, that is deletion of a node with two child nodes. So in this case, what you have to do? You have to either replace this 30 with the in-order predecessor, which is the largest element in the left subtree, or the in-order successor, which is the smallest element in the right subtree. Right. So let us go with the in-order successor. There is no problem, anything you can choose. So let us discuss what is happening in this in-order successor case. So what is the in-order successor of 30?
38.
So you have to find the smallest element in the right hand side, right subtree. So the smallest element is 38. So remember that deletion is not the actual deletion, right? So you, first of all, you have to perform a copy operation. So 38 is copied or replaced by this, 30 is replaced with 38, and then you recursively apply the same deletion operation where you will come across this particular node, right? Now you have to delete this 38 here. So as you know that 38 is red and the nil leaves, are black in nature. So this is nothing but case 1. Am I right or not?
Yes, sir.
Case 1 is nothing but deletion of a node with 0 child. So you will just replace this 38 with the black node. So this becomes a black node. So instead of representing the black node, you can simply remove this entire thing. Right, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now you check whether the given tree, the resultant tree, is the red black tree or not. Tell me what is the black height of each and every path. Tell me how many paths are there.
8, sir.
Right. So we have 8, 1. Ayyo. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what is the black height of the first path?
2, sir.
This is 2. What about this third path? 2, 2. And here 1 and 2, 2, 2. Here 1 and 2, 2. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
So this is how you delete the red node. And let us discuss this particular case after discussing case 3, right? So what is case 2 here? If the root is double black, just remove the double black. We will discuss it later. Let us discuss this case 3, which says that if double black's sibling is black and both of his children are black, remove the double black. Add one part of the black to his parent. If the parent is red, it will become black. If the parent is black, it will become double black. And mark the sibling as red. This analogy I have given, right? So if I had a problem, I will ask my brother. If my brother is black, I will check for his children. If the children are also black, I will simply throw my problem to the parent. So when I throw my problem to the parent, they are ready to accept. My father is ready to accept my problem. So even though he is red or black, it won't bother. You simply throw it, that's it. So if the parent, or if my father is red, he will become black. If my father is black, he will become double black. So since you are troubling your parent, or since you are troubling your father, your brother becomes angry on you. So you have to change the color of sibling to red. If still DB exists, apply the other cases. That is what you have to do. Now consider this example. Is it visible, this example?
Yes, sir.
Now I want to delete 15. So I have to perform a search operation. 15 compared with 10 greater than, 15 compared with 20 less than. So go to its left hand side, 15 identified here. Now listen carefully. When I want to remove this 15, what is the color of this 15?
Black,
right. So I have to replace it with the left child or right child. Why? Because if I take the in order predecessor, this becomes the in order predecessor. If I take the in order successor, this becomes the in order successor. So I have to replace this 15 with the in order successor or in order predecessor. Anything is okay, right? So when I replace this 15 with the black color or black node, now my node becomes like this. This one. So this becomes double black. Can you see this one? Double black. I represent double black with two circles. Right?
Yes, sir.
And what is the color of this two circle node?
Double black.
So as I told that, I represent the double black with DB. Right. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now I had a double black here. Let me consider that I am sitting here at this particular double black. So when I had a problem, what is the first option I have? To whom you have to ask?
Sibling.
You have to ask your brother or sister, right? So I go and check that 30 is my sibling, and is the brother in a position to accept your problem? Right. How can you identify whether your brother is ready to accept or not? By looking at his color. If he is red, he is ready to accept. But if he is black, he is not ready to accept. Now tell me whether my sibling 30 is ready to accept my problem or not.
No, sir.
No, why? Because he is black. He is already black. So he won't take the risk. So what is the second option I have?
Brother, children.
Siblings, children.
Children of brother. What are the children nodes of brothers?
Nil nodes.
Nil nodes. What is the color of the children nodes now?
Black.
Black nodes. They are also not in a position to accept. So what is the final option I have?
Parent.
So I simply throw my problem to the parent. Throwing the problem to the parent in the sense, you just throw one part of your black. You just throw one part of your black to the parent. Forget about the color of the parent. He is ready to accept. So what I will do is, I will simply remove this double black. The first step I am implementing. This one. So I removed my double black and this becomes black. Am I right or not?
Yes, sir.
Now you throw one part of the black to the parent. So what is the color of the parent?
Black, sir.
black. So if the parent is black and I am throwing one black to him, he will readily accept it and he will become double black. Like this. So when I throw my problem to the parent, he readily accepts and he is converted into double black. But what happens to the brother?
He gets angry.
It becomes
so he gets angry. Why you are troubling the parent all the time? So he gets angry and changes his color from black to red. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So if yes, still sir. Double black exists, apply other cases. Is there any double black node here? Can I remove this node, which is a single black and does not consist of any value?
Yes, sir.
So it is nothing but a nil leaf, so I am just removing it. So in this particular example, now in this particular situation, do you have any double black node? 20. Right. So I had a double black node at 20. Now I assume that this is my position. I am here. Right, I am here now. Now tell me. So whenever you have a double black, what is the first option I have to do? I have to ask my sibling. I have gone through the sibling. What is the sibling of 20?
5, sir.
5, right. What is the color of 5?
Black.
Black. Is he ready to accept my problem?
No, sir.
No. So I go for nephews. What are the nephews for 20?
1 and 7.
Nephews and amma, it's not nephews, I think, right? So siblings, children are nothing but my children.
Children, right? Yes.
Children only, right? So I ask the children of my brother. I check the colors of that one, right? So I found that the children of my brother are also black. So they are also not in a position to accept. So what I should do? The last option. Worst case.
Parent.
So you throw your problem to the parent. So what you will do is, you will remove this double black. Right. You will remove this double black. 20. And you throw one part of your black to your parent. Right. So this becomes double black. Like this. Up to here you are clear, right?
Yes, sir.
Now comes the second case. So here you can observe that the double black exists, but the double black is at the root node. Root does not have any sibling. Root does not have any parents. So how can he solve his problem? The root node. He will simply remove the double black. That's it. Right. So
sir,
what
we have to
do?
Make sibling red.
Which one, amma? Yeah. Super. This particular point I am forgetting all the time. Why? Because my brother will not be angry. So 5 becomes red. And you can observe here that 10 is the root node and it is the double black. Since it does not have any sibling and parents, what it will do is, he will simply remove the double black. You should not remove the node, right? You should remove only the double black. This one. So the final result you get here is this one. Now check and tell me whether this forms the red black or not. So how many nil descendant parts are there?
7.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Super. Now tell me, what is the black height of path 1?
2, sir.
2. Here also we have 2. Here 1, 2. 1, 2. Here also we have 2. Here we have 2 and 2. Now this forms a red black tree. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes.
Clear, sir.
Right. Now we'll go back to case 2 and we'll discuss what happens in this case. Right. So if the root is double black, just remove double black. That's it. Nothing wrong in it. Now look at this one. Delete 20. So I found that 20 is at this location and I found that it is red in color. Forget about what if it is red, what you have to do? You have to consider the cases of binary search tree. So this 20 is having two nodes. Right. Here you have to observe one important point. Listen carefully. So you have to check the two children nodes. This 20 is having two child nodes. So you have two options, whether you can replace it with the in order successor or you can replace it with the in order predecessor. If it is in order predecessor, replace it with 15. If it is in order successor, you replace it with 30. So we'll take the in order successor. So what you have to do, you have to copy this 30 at this location. Right. Listen carefully. So you are copying a black node into a red node. So what happens here is the internal nodes retain their color. What is that one? What is the point that I have told here?
Internal nodes retain their color.
Internal nodes retain their color. What does it mean? So even though you can observe here, even though you are copying a black node into a red node, it will not convert into black node. It will retain its color. This is the important point we have to remember. So the point is internal nodes retain their color. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
So when you copy this 30 here, you are just copying it. That is the reason why there is no change in color. So this particular, when you recursively apply it, this particular 30 is replaced with nil leaf. It will be replaced with nil leaf. Therefore, this becomes black, right? So I can remove this one. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. So this particular example is taken to explain this particular concept. This is not an example to, if the root is double black, just remove DB. This is not the example for this. So the point here you have to remember in this example is the internal nodes retain their color. That is what I have to explain. Is it clear?
Sir, what about black height, sir?
What happened to black height? Okay.
It is not satisfying.
Last part is not satisfying.
This one is not satisfied, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
One minute. Here it is not satisfied. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Let me just verify it.
Okay, sir.
relation of black with the black child. Deletion of black with the black child. This becomes so when you want to delete 20, you just go through it. Okay, but this part I will rectify it in the next session, maybe in this session only. But let me go through the other cases, right? Let me go through this case 4. Right.
Okay, sir.
So case 4 is if double black's sibling is red, what you have to do? My brother is having red color, so he is ready to accept, but I don't have direct communication with my brother. So what I will do is, I will ask my parent to talk to my brother. So my parent will go and talk to the brother, and he also says the same thing. I am ready to solve the problem of my brother, but I cannot directly communicate with him. So what we will do is, we had a deal. We will exchange our colors, and whatever you want to do, you do later. That is what the deal is, right? So once you swap the color, case 4, case 5 and case 6 are very important. So once you swap the colors, the second part is you have to rotate the things, right? Since you are requesting your brother via your parent, so you have to rotate the parent. And as I told, that parent always rotates in the DB direction only. So wherever we have this double black node, in that direction the rotation will happen. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. So you take this example and try to remove 15. So when I remove 15, what happens here? So 15, the color of 15 is black. So when I want to replace it with a nil leaf node, which is a black, like this. So this 15 is replaced with
double black,
like this. So when you have a double black, you have to, what is the first option you have to do? You have to check your sibling. So what is the sibling you have? Your sibling is red in color, therefore he is ready to accept. But since you don't have the communication, you ask your parent and parent will ask. When the parent asks your brother, can you do some favor to your brother, then he readily accepts. But since there is no direct communication, your parent and brother will have a deal. So dad, we will exchange our colors first. So swap the color of the sibling
and parent.
So this becomes red and this becomes black, right? So after swapping, this is very important, you will get confused at this point. After swapping, it is mandatory that you should rotate the things, right? You should rotate the things. Don't apply the other cases. Other cases means I had a double black here, my brother is also black, their sons are also black, therefore I have no option, I can simply throw my problem to the parent. Since it is red, it becomes black. That is not the case, right? Once you swap the colors between the parent and the sibling, you have to rotate the parent, right? Who is parent here?
20.
And as I told, that parent always has a tendency to rotate towards a child who is having a problem. So rotate parent in the DB direction, in the double black direction. So after rotation, let me draw the diagram. So the left child or the left subtree of 10 will remain as it is. It is black and this is black, this is black and this is black. Right. Now if you rotate this particular node around 20, what happens? 30 will move forward. Am I right or not?
Yes, sir.
30 will move forward and 20 becomes the left child. And who is the left child of 20? Double black.
Double.
Right. And the right child of 30, that is 40, remains as it is. But what happens to this 25? That is the left child of 30. It will be placed as the right child of 20. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now let me draw the colors. B, red, B, and this is DB, right? And this is black. So once you rotate, we will forget, we will definitely forget this case. But remember that swapping always followed by the rotate. Right? So once you rotate, you have to reapply the cases. Now again, check. This is the DB. Go for its sibling. What is the color of its sibling?
Black.
Black. What is the colors of its children?
Black.
Black only. Nil leaves are considered as black, right? So these three, the sibling, sibling's child cannot take my problem. So I go to my parent. I just throw my, remove this double black. I just remove this double black. And this becomes a single black, like this, right? So what happens to the color? Color of 20?
Black, sir.
Black, sir.
It becomes black. But remember, here also you will forget one thing. Since you are troubling your parent, what happens to your brother?
Black. Becomes red, sir.
He becomes angry, right? Therefore, this becomes red. Can I remove this nil leaf?
Yes,
can
sir.
I remove this nil leaf? Now check whether this is the red black tree or not. So how red many black parts black are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, amma.
9,
sir. Right. So the black height of first path is? What is the
three,
black
sir
height of this path?
Three,
this
sir
is 3, second path is 3, and this is 3, and this is 3, and 1, 2, and 3. This is 3, 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3. Is it clear up to this point?
Clear, sir.
Right. We'll go for the next case. Somewhat tougher cases we are dealing with now. Right. So if DB's sibling is black, my brother is black, but one of his child is red in color. Now you have to check whether it is a near child who is red or the farthest child who is red. If it is near child, then you have to swap color of the sibling with the near child color. And then you have to make a rotate. Here rotation. Here rotation has to be done via the sibling. So once you do the rotation via the sibling, it should be in the opposite direction of DB. And then it will be automatically converted into case 6, where you will apply case 6. Therefore, the near child becomes far child. We'll see what happens in case 6. Right. Is it clear? Now let us see with an example. So let us take this one and I am trying to delete 1. So if I try to delete 1, what happens? First of all, I have to search for 1. I found 1 is present as the last element towards the left side of 10. Right. So if I want to delete that node, I have to check the color. It is black in nature. So what happens? What is that you have to do? It becomes double black. Right. Now you had a double black. Now you have to apply the cases. So if there is a double black, I have to check my siblings. My sibling is in which color?
Black.
What about the children of my sibling?
Black.
If everybody is black, I don't have any option. I have only option to exchange parent. My problem with the parent. What is the color of parent?
Black.
So once I exchange the color with my parent, I can remove this. Is it true or not?
Yes, sir. Parent becomes double black.
Parent becomes double black. And remember what happens to brother?
Red becomes red.
He becomes red. Right. Now still my DB exists. So I should check the sibling of 5. Who is the sibling of 5?
30.
Check for the color of your sibling, black. So I don't have option with my brother. So I will go and check the children of my brother. So one of the child of my brother is having the red color. Right. Now you have to identify whether he is the near child or far child. Now tell me, what is the node value that is having red?
25.
Now tell me whether he is a near child or far child.
Near child.
So if he is a near child, what we'll do is you will ask your sibling to check whether the near child is ready to accept the problem or not, right? So this 30 will go and ask 25. My brother is having some problem, could you please solve it, right? So he will readily accept. Any child will accept, whether he is a near child or far child, forget about it, they will accept. But the thing is, we have to perform the different actions with respect to the near child and far child. So if it is a near child, yes, dad, I can help your brother. But since I don't have a direct communication with your brother, first of all, let us have a deal. Let us exchange our colors first. So what happens? You have to swap the color of the sibling and sibling's child, which is near to DB. So what happens here?
30 becomes red
and 25 becomes black, right? And since the 30 is made angry, the sibling will move away from the double black. So my brother will move away from it. So after swapping, as I told that, you should perform a definite rotate operation. Rotation with respect to parent is towards the double black, and rotation with respect to sibling is away from the double black, right? So to which direction I have to rotate?
Right side.
So once I rotate, let me redraw the diagram first. This is black and this is double black. And tell me, what happens here? When I rotate towards his right hand side, around 30.
25
move upward. And what happens to 30? It remains as the right child, and 40. Here 40 remains the right child. And what happens to 20? 20 remains as the right child. But what happens to 28? This is important.
Right side of
30. Right. What about the colors here? this is black, right? This is black. And what happens to 20? This is also black. What about 30? It is red. And 28 is black and 40 is black. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now apply case 6. As I told that when you fall into the category of case 5, you will be automatically directed towards the case 6 only because of the rotations and swappings, right? So what is case 6? What is case 6? If the sibling is black, sibling's near child is black and far child is red. This is the case we have, right? So I have double black. What is the color of my sibling?
Black.
Black. What black. Is the color of my near child of my sibling?
Black.
Black. What is the color of the far child of my sibling? It is
red.
So it goes into the case 6. So in case 6, what you can do? You cannot directly communicate with the far child, or you cannot communicate with the sibling. So you will put your father as the mediator. You will ask your father, "Dad, please go and ask the brother." Right? Father will go and ask the brother, saying that your brother is having some problem. You please ask your child to rectify it. Right? So he will readily accept, not an issue. But before that, what he will do is, there is a swap of colors between the parent and the sibling. This is very important, case 6, right? Previously, there is a swap of color between the sibling and sibling's child, red colored child. But here, since this is a far child red node, and the swapping of colors should be done between the parent and the sibling. Don't forget about this. Right. In some cases you will come across the red also, that is not a case, right? Here the parent and sibling are both black in nature. Am I right or not?
Yes, sir.
So if there is a swap, what happens to the swap operation? Nothing change will be there. Why? Because the parent is already black, it remains as black, and the sibling is black, it remains as black only. So after swap operation, both of them remain as it is. And one important point I told regarding this deletion is, swap operation is always, tell me, swap operation is always succeeded by
rotations.
Rotation, right? So what rotation you have to do? Since the parent has been involved, you have to rotate your tree, your tree with respect to the parents and in the direction of DB. So this is how you have to rotate. So once you rotate, what happens here? Tell me.
25 becomes root node.
Super. 25 becomes root node, and 10 becomes the left child, and 5, which is a double black, remains as it is, right? So 10 is black and 25 is also black. And the right child of 25, that is 30, and this is 40, they remain as it is, right? What happens to 20?
Right of 10.
Right of 10, right? So you can see here, what is the first step we have performed?
Sir, when it is a far,
sir, you left 28.
Left of 30, sir, 28.
Yeah, sorry. Left of 30. Right. Super. So when the far child is red, swap color of parent and sibling, then rotate parent P in the direction of DB, then remove DB, this is what important, remove DB and change color for red to black, right. So what is that you have to do? You have to remove this DB. Five, this becomes black. And what is the color here? You have to change the black color of far child from red to black. Right. Now tell me whether this is a red black tree or not. How many parts are there?
Eight
parts.
Eight,
so what is the black height?
Three, sir.
Three, sir.
3 3 3 3 3 3 3 3. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Clear, sir.
So we have seen all the six different cases in the deletion part of this red black trace, right? Except we have that doubt in that particular case where if you want to delete what is that one? What is the doubt we have there?
The root is double
black.
Right. And it is not satisfying the case, right? So let me check it out. Where we have done the mistake? Case 2, right?
50 becomes red and 30 becomes black, sir, maybe.
Right. 1 minute. Let me take the previous one only. What is that here? Could you remember that element? I think 20.
20, sir.
And it is red and it is 30, which is black. Right. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Listen. So, what is the problem we have done is maybe my part is to delete 20. Okay. I identified that 20 is the in this case. And it is red in color and it is to case 3, right, where a node is having 2 children. So I can replace it with the in order successor. So in order successor is 30. So first of all, I will just copy the things. I will just copy this 30, sorry, this becomes 30, right. Is it clear?
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, you apply the deletion part again recursively. So, here I have black and black. Now, here I got it. Here we missed this part. Right. So, if I want to delete 30, can I delete it as it is? It is a black node, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It is a black node.
Make it.
So what happens here?
It becomes double black, sir.
It becomes double black. That is the problem. Let us check. I don't know whether I will get the solution or not. So this becomes double black. Now tell me, if it is a double black, if it is a double black, what is the thing you have to do?
It should ask sibling, sir.
You should check its sibling. So what is the sibling of this double black? 15.
Black, sir.
It is black. What is the child of this 15?
Black, sir.
Black, sir. So they are not in a position to accept, right?
Parent.
So I should throw my problem to the parent. So I remove my double black. One part of my black is thrown to this particular parent. So what happens here? Sorry, sir. So this becomes a single black, which I can remove, right? So what happens to 30? It is moved from, it is converted from red
it
to
black.
Black. But, and you have to remember, since you are troubling your parent, your brother will get angry. So this becomes red. Is it clear?
Yes,
is it
sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now
yes,
tell
sir.
Me whether this is the red black tree or not. How many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Five, sir.
Five. What is the black height of this particular path in this path?
Two, sir.
Two. This one, two.
Two,
this
sir.
One, two. This one, two. This one, two. Now it is clear, right?
Yes, sir.
So I have discussed. We have discussed. In fact, you are also active. So we have discussed all the six cases of deletion of these red black trees with examples. I think it is clear at this particular point, right? So one thing I want to do is, I just want to give you one assignment, simple assignment, right? You please take the screenshot of this one. Right.
Yes, sir.
Please take the screenshot and you try to delete the elements in the order of this one. First you have to delete 55 from the resultant red black tree. You check whether it is red black tree or not. From the resultant red black tree you delete 30 and then 90, 80, 50, 35, 15, 65 and 68. You have to do it and take it as an assignment. Right, I didn't give any assignments right now, right?
Yes, sir.
So you take it as an assignment and you please try to submit it on A4 sheets.
Okay, sir.
So you have taken this screenshot of this example, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Thank you. So this completes the entire discussion on the red black trees, where we have discussed the introduction part to red black trees, the properties of red black trees, what are the differences between the red black trees and the AVL trees, and what are some of the important points regarding these AVL trees. And then we have discussed the insertion operation by giving a list of elements, and today in today's session we have gone through the deletion operation with the examples also, right? So that's all for this is the end of the red black trees discussion, and that's all for today's session. And in next session we try to start another topic on splay trees. That is also a simple topic, right? So that is how I have planned. From the next session onwards we will be dealing with the splay trees. So thank you one and all for these 2 hours of classes. Thank you.